Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to teleclass of grade 10 mathematics.
Hello, I'm Zumra Miss from Tajuddin School. I hope you all are staying home and safe. Before starting today's lesson, let's recall some key points from the topic probability.
When calculating the probability of an event occurring, we write number of desired outcomes over total number of possible outcomes. Independent events such as a coin toss are not affected by previous events. Dependent events such as removing marbles from a bag are affected by previous events. Mutually exclusive events: when you flip a coin, you might get head or tail. Both cannot happen together. Such events are mutually exclusive events. Two basic rules are in probability: the end rule, multiply their probabilities together, or rule, add their probabilities together. As we all know that something may happen or it may not happen, but when we combine these two probabilities, it will always add up to 1. So if the probability of an outcome of an event happening is P, then the probability of it not happening is 1 minus P. Alright, let me ask one question. Two coins are tossed at the same time. List all the possible outcomes of this event. Did you get 4 possibilities? Yeah, I used T for tail and H for head. You might get tail and tail, head and head, tail and head, head and tail. Also, we can use a possibility diagram. Here it displays all the possible outcomes in a table, right? Here's one more question. 3 coins are tossed at the same time. List all the possible outcomes of this event. Can we display this event in a possibility diagram? No, right? Because possibility diagram can only show outcomes for 2 events, such as one die is rolled in 2 times, or 2 unbiased 6-sided dice are rolled, or a coin is tossed and a die is rolled at the same time, or when 2 balls are selected one at a time with replacement. One of the possibility is HHH. Here, outcome for the first coin is head, outcome for the second coin is head, outcome for the third coin is head, written as HHH. Can you list all other combinations of this event? It takes a little bit of time to think and list, right? Did you get 8 total outcomes? Right. Very good. In experiment like this, it is convenient to use a tree diagram to list all the outcomes of each stage in a clear and a systemic way. Well, in this class, I am going to focus on tree diagram. We will be learning how to use tree diagrams to show all the possible outcomes of combined events for independent and dependent events. Calculate the probability of combined events using tree diagram. We will be successful if we can draw a tree diagram to organize the outcomes for simple combined events, find the probability of each branch of a tree diagram, and calculate the probability of combined events using tree diagrams. What is probability tree diagram? A tree diagram is a branching diagram that shows all the possible outcomes of one or more events. Two main components are the branches, the ends, used to calculate probabilities of combined events. Tree diagrams are useful when there are more than 2 events to show all possible outcomes. Now let's see how we draw probability tree diagram. Example 1. A fair coin is tossed twice. Draw a tree diagram to show all the possible outcomes of this event. You can use H for head and T for tail. To draw a tree diagram, make a dot to represent the first event. From the dot, branches are drawn to represent all possible outcomes of the event. Here in first toss, we have 2 possible outcomes, that is head and 10. Draw two lines from this dot. Then write the outcome at the end of each branch. One and head, other and tail. Now the probability of getting each outcome is 1 over 2. Then write the probability of each outcome on its branch. Clear? Second toss. Assume we got head in the first toss. We might get head or tail in the second toss. We have two possible outcomes. Draw a double branch like this. Label two ends. And then write the probability of each outcome on its branch. Similarly, we got a tail in the first toss. We are assuming we got tail in the first toss. We might get head or tail. Draw a double branch like that. And then label two ends and write the probability of each outcome on its branch. Now, when we combine these two events, we get head and head, head and tail, tail and head, tail and tail. There are four total possible outcomes. Clear? Let's see another example. Let's try. Three coins are tossed together. Draw a tree diagram to show all the possible outcomes of this event. For the first event, we have two possibilities. Two possible outcomes. Draw a double branch like this. Write the outcomes at the end of each branch. One end head, other end tail. That is H, H for head and T for tail. In the second event, again we have two possibilities. Draw a double branch like this. Label two ends. One end H, other end T. For each coin we have two possible outcomes. We might get head or tail. Repeat this at the end of each branch for the second and third event. Now list all the possible combination of this event. Outcome for the first coin is H. Outcome for the second coin is H. Outcome for the third coin is H. Written as HHH, which means we are getting three heads. Likewise, you can list all the other combination of this event. Clear? Did you get eight total possible outcomes? Well done. Very good. Example 2. Draw a tree diagram to show all the possible outcomes for throwing an unbiased die and tossing a fair coin at the same time. Here, throwing a die, you have 6 possibilities. Draw 6 lines from this dot. Then, write the outcomes at the end of each branch. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, it's an unbiased die. Probability of getting each outcome is 1 over 6. Now write the probability of each outcome on its branch. Tossing a coin, we have two possibilities. Draw a double branch like this. Label two ends, one end H, other end T, H for head, T for tail. Repeat the same step to complete the tree diagram. It's also a fair coin. Probability of getting each outcome is 1 over 2. Write the probability of each outcome on its branch. Okay? Let's list all the combination of this event. Outcomes are 1 and head, 1 and tail, 2 and head, 2 and tail. Like this, you can list all the combination of this event. Clear? Now, to find the probability of one particular combination of outcomes, we multiply their probabilities along the branches. Here, for example, probability of getting 1 and head. We multiply 1 over 6 times 1 over 2, equals 1 over 12. Clear? Look at this example. A bag contains 4 red marbles and 2 blue marbles. 2 marbles are chosen at random from the bag with replacement. Draw a tree diagram to show all the possible outcomes. Well, first start off by drawing tree diagram. Look at the first choice. We might pick a blue marble or red marble. Draw a double branch like this. Label 2 ends, 1 end R, other end B. R for red, B for blue. Now write the probability of each outcome on its branch. Out of 6, there are 4 red marbles and 2 blue marbles. The probability of picking a red marble is 4 over 6 and the probability of picking a blue marble is 2 over 6. Right? Second choice. Assume we picked a red marble in the first choice. We note it and replace it. In the second choice also, we might take red or blue marble. We have 2 possibilities. Draw a double branch like this. Label 2 ends. Whatever we pick on the first choice, we replaced. Therefore, the situation becomes the same as before, which means this is an independent event. Here, the first choice has no influence on the second choice. So, the probability of picking a red marble is 4 over 6, same as before, and the probability of picking a blue marble is 2 over 6, right? Okay, assume we picked a blue marble in the first choice. We noted and replace it. In the second choice also, we might take red or blue marble. Draw a double branch like that. Table 2 ends. And the probability of picking a red marble is 4 over 6. And the probability of picking a blue marble is 2 over 6. Right? Now let's list all the combination of these two events. We might get red and red, red and blue, blue and red, or blue and blue. Clear? There are 4 total possible outcomes. Now let's calculate the probability for each outcome. To calculate the probability of each outcome, we multiply their probabilities along the branches. That is R and R 16 over 36, R and B 8 over 36, B and R 8 over 36, B and B 4 over 36. Now we know that when we add probabilities of all the outcomes of that event, it will always add up to 1. Now let's see how we use tree diagram to calculate the probability equations. A. Use the tree diagram to find the probability of obtaining 2 blue marbles. Here there is only 1 chance that obtain 2 blue marbles, right? Along the branch, we multiply their probabilities. Already we calculate the probability for this outcome. Answer is 4 over 36. After reducing, we get 1 over 9. Is that clear? Very good. Let's move on the next slide. B. Use the tree diagram to find the probability of 2 marbles of the same color. Here there are 2 possible outcomes that obtain 2 marbles of the same color. You might get red and red or blue and blue, which means this is a mutually exclusive event. Both outcomes cannot happen together, right? So when events are mutually exclusive, add the probabilities obtained by multiplication. Calculate the probability of each combination by multiplying their probabilities along the branches. Add 2 probabilities. Answer is 5 over 9. Is that clear? Very good. C. Use the tree diagram to find the probability of at least 1 red. Out of 4 outcomes, there are 3 possibilities that have at least 1 red. We might get R and R or R and B or B and R. Yes, it's a mutually exclusive event. So, when events are mutually exclusive, add the probabilities obtained by multiplication. You can add these three probabilities. Answer is 8 over 9. Clear? Here is another quick method that we use to find the probability of at least one red. We know that all outcomes except blue and blue have one red. And we also know that when we add probabilities of all the outcomes of that event, it will always add up to 1. So we use this idea. The probability of an event occurring is 1 minus the probability of the event not occurring. Here you can subtract probability of blue and blue from 1. Answer is 8 over 9. Clear? That's quick, right? Let's do this question. Maya and Bina are going for an interview. The probability that Maya will arrive early is 0.7. The probability that Bina will arrive early is 0.4. The two events are independent. Complete the probability tree diagram. First, find the probability for this branch. We know that when we add probabilities of all the outcomes of that event, it will always add up to 1. You can subtract 0.7 from 1, answer is 0.3. Write the probability for this branch. 0.4 minus from 1, that is 0.6. The two events are independent. You can fill two branches. That is 0.4, 0.6. I used E for early and N for not early. B, work out the probability that Maya and Bina will both arrive early. There is only one chance that both arrive early. Right? So along the branch you multiply, answer is 0.28. C, work out the probability that just one person will arrive early. For this, there are two outcomes. Right? Yes, it's a mutually exclusive event. Along the branch, first to multiply their probabilities and then add two probabilities. Answer is 0.6. Is that clear? Very good.
From this topic, that much content covered in core syllabus.
Tree diagrams for combined dependent events. It's only included in the extended syllabus. A bag contains 4 blue balls and 2 orange balls. 2 balls are chosen at random from the bag without replacement. Draw a tree diagram to show all the possible outcomes. Look at the first choice. We have 2 possibilities. Draw a double branch like this. Label 1 and B, other and O, B for blue and O for orange. Out of 6, there are 4 blue balls and 2 orange balls. Probability of picking a blue ball is 4 over 6 and probability of picking an orange ball is 2 over 6. Look at the second choice.
Assume this is that bag. I took a blue ball from this bag. Now, how many outcomes are there? Now, there are 5 outcomes. Now, in the second choice, I might take a blue ball or an orange ball. Now, what is the probability of picking a blue ball now? That is 3 over 5 because I am not replacing. And what is the probability of picking an orange ball? That is 2 over 5.
Assume we picked a blue ball in the first choice. In the second choice also, we might take the blue or an orange ball. Draw a double branch like this and label 2 and 1 and B, other and O. Here we are not replacing. The number of total outcomes decreased by 1. Now we have 5 balls. And the probability of picking a blue ball is 3 over 5. And the probability of picking an orange ball is 2 over 5. Right? Like the probability of each outcome on its branch. Okay? Similarly, we assumed we picked an orange ball in the first choice. Draw a double branch, label 2 ends. Here the probability of picking an orange ball is now 1 over 5. And the probability of picking a blue ball is 4 over 5. Write the probability of each outcome on its branch. Now let's see what are the combinations we are getting when we combine these two events. Outcomes are blue and blue, blue and orange, orange and blue, orange and orange. Now let's calculate the probability for each outcome. We multiply their probabilities along the branches. Here it is 12 over 30, 8 over 30, 8 over 30, 2 over 30. Clear? Let's use this tree diagram to calculate the probability equations. A. Use the tree diagram to calculate the probability of 2 blue balls. There's only one chance that you can obtain 2 blue balls. Along the branch you multiply, answer is 2 over 5. Right? Next. Use the tree diagram to calculate the probability of 2 different colors. There are 2 outcomes that gives 2 different colors. You might take blue and orange or orange and blue. It's a mutually exclusive event. Cannot happen together. So along the branch, we multiply their probabilities. After that, we add 2 probabilities. Answer is 8 over 15. This is also a quick way that if 2 probabilities are same, you can just multiply 2 times 8 over 30. Answer is 8 over 15. Clear? Next. C. Use the tree diagram to calculate the probability of at least 1 orange. Here there are 3 possibilities that gives at least 1 orange. You might get blue and orange, or orange and blue, or orange and orange. It's a mutually exclusive event. First, along the branch, you multiply the probability of each combination, then add 3 possibilities. Yes, there's a quick way. 1 minus BB. You can use that method too. Answer is 3 over 5. Alright.
Here's another interesting example. Let's just read the question. Bag A contains 2 pentagons and 2 triangles. Bag B contains 3 pentagons and 2 triangles. A shape is chosen at random from bag A, the shape noted, and then the shape is placed in bag B. A shape is then chosen at random from bag B. Complete the probability tree diagram. In the first choice, we have to select a shape from bag A. Draw a double branch because we have 2 possible outcomes. Label 2 ones, 1 and P, other and T, P for pentagon, T for triangle. Now write the probability of each outcome on its branch. Here the probability of picking a pentagon is 2 over 4 and the probability of picking a triangle is 2 over 4. Now assume we picked a pentagon from bag A, placed in bag B. Then we have to select a shape from bag B. We have 2 possible outcomes. The probability of picking a pentagon from bag B is 4 over 6. And the probability of picking a triangle from bag B is 2 over 6. Write the probability of each outcome on its branch.
Assumed we picked a triangle from bag A and placed in bag B. And we are going to choose another shape from bag B. We have 2 possibilities. Draw a double branch like this. Label 2 ends, 1 and P, other and T. Now the probability of picking a triangle is 3 over 6 and the probability of picking a pentagon is 3 over 6 from bag B. Right? Now let's list all the outcomes for this event. Outcomes are pentagon and pentagon, pentagon and triangle, triangle and pentagon, and triangle and triangle. There are four total outcomes. Let's see another question. B. Find the probability of choosing two different shapes. We have two possibilities that gives two different shapes. You might take pentagon and triangle or triangle and pentagon. So it's a mutually exclusive event. Along the branch, first multiply their probabilities. After that, you can add their probabilities. Answer is 5 over 12. Is that clear? Very good. Here is your turn to try. First, read the question carefully. Then, highlight the keywords. Let me help you. It's very useful to highlight the important information that is given in the question. Right? Complete the probability tree diagram. First, you can find the probability for this branch. We know that for every event, when we add probabilities of all the outcomes of that event, it will always add up to 1. So 1 minus 0.4, that is 0.6. 1 minus 0.25, that is 0.75. 1 minus 0.35, that is 0.65. Right? B. Find the probability that when Rose next drives to the shops, she will not stop at the second set of traffic lights. There are two possibilities, right? Which means it's a mutually exclusive event. Along the branch, first multiply their probabilities. After that, add two probabilities. That is 0.69. Is that okay? That's all about tree diagram. Let's summarize our lesson. A tree diagram is a clear way of showing all the possible outcomes of combined events. It's used to calculate probabilities of combined events, useful when there are more than two stages. Outcomes are written at the end of branches on a tree diagram. The probability of each outcome is written as fraction or decimal. For independent events, we multiply along the branches. When events are mutually exclusive, add the probabilities obtained by multiplication. All right. Here is your task. First, do exercise 24.2, page 600, question 2, 3, and 4. And there is self-assessment. You can go to quizizz.com, enter game code 8814074. Code will be expired on June 30th.
I hope you enjoyed the lesson. Thank you. Have a nice day. Wassalamu alaikum.